19th February 2021, मॉर्निंग मुरली, ओम शांति बाप दादा मधुबन, स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, यू आर नाउ चेंजिंग दिस ग्रेवयार्ड इंटू द लैंड ऑफ एंजल्स, देयरफॉर यू लेट देयर बी कंप्लीट दिस एंट्रेंस इन दिस ओल्ड वर्ल्ड दिस ग्रेवयार्ड. क्वेश्चन, हाउ इज द अनलिमिटेड फादर the wonderful servant of his spiritual children? Answer, Baba says, children, I am your laundryman. I wash all the dirty clothes of not only you children, but of the whole world in a second. When the clothes of you souls become clean, you receive pure bodies. He is such a wonderful servant that he cleanses everyone in a second with a magic mantra of Manmana Bhava. Om Shanti. The father has explained to you children the meaning of Om Shanti, the original religion of myself. The soul is peace. You don't need to make effort to go to the land of peace. A soul is himself an embodiment of peace, a resident of the land of peace. Yes, a soul can remain peaceful for some time. The soul says, I have become tired of the burden of the physical senses. I am now stabilizing myself in my original religion. I am becoming detached from the body. However, actions have to be performed. For how long can you remain seated in peace? The soul says, I am a resident of the peaceful land. By coming here into a body, I have become talky. I, the soul, am imperishable and my body is perishable. Souls became pure and impure in the golden age. Even the five elements are satopradhan. Here, the five elements are tamopradhan. When alloy is mixed into gold, that gold becomes impure. It is then put into fire to be purified. Thus is called the fire of yoga. In the world outside, people teach many different types of Hatha Yoga. None of those can be called the fire of yoga. This is the fire of yoga in which sins are burnt away. It is the supreme soul who makes souls pure from impure. People call out, oh, purifier, come. According to the drama plan, everyone has to become impure, tamapradhan. This is the tree and its seed is up above. When anyone calls out to the father, his intellect goes upward. He is the one from whom you are claiming your inheritance and he has now come down here. He says, I have to come here. The human world tree of the variety of religions is now impure and tamopradhan. It has reached the state of total decay. The father sits here and explains to you children, there are deities in the golden age and devils in the iron age. Therefore, no war ever takes place between deities and devils. You are gaining victory over the five devilish vices with the power of yoga. There is no question of a violent war. You don't commit any type of violence. You never physically hit anyone. You are doubly non-violent. To use the sword of lust is the greatest sin. The father says, the sword of lust causes sorrow from its beginning through the middle to the end. No one should indulge in vice. People sing praise in front of the deity idols. You are full of all virtues. Souls say, I have become impure. That is why They call out, "Oh, purifier, come." When souls are pure, they don't call out to anyone. That is called heaven. Here, sages and holy men chant so much, "Oh, purifier, Ram, who belongs to Sita." The father says, "At this time, the whole world is impure. No one can be blamed for this. This drama is predestined. Until I come, everyone has to play his own part. There is knowledge, devotion, and then disinterest. Disinterest in the old world, this disinterest is unlimited, whereas their disinterest is limited. You understand that this old world is not to be destroyed. When a new home is being built, there is disinterest in the old home. The unlimited father says, I am now building the home of heaven and giving that to you. It is now hell. Heaven is the new world and hell is the old world. We are now creating the new world by living in the old world. We will build the land of angels over the old graveyard. There will be the same banks of the river Jamuna, and palaces will be built on them. There will be the same Delhi and river Jamuna. However, it is just a tall story when people say that there was the fortress of the Pandavas. According to the drama plan, this will definitely be built again. So, just as you had been doing tapasya, holding sacrificial fires and giving donations, you will have to do all of that again. First, you worship Shiva and build first class temples to him. That is called unadulterated worship. You are now on the path of knowledge. This is unadulterated knowledge. You only hear this from Shubhaba, the one who worship first of all. At that time, means in the golden age, there were no other religions. Only you existed then and you were very happy. The deity religion is one that gives a lot of happiness. Your mouths are sweetened as soon as the name is mentioned. Only from the one father do you receive this knowledge. The father says, don't listen to anyone else. This is your unadulterated knowledge. You now belong to the unlimited father. You will receive your inheritance from the father number wise. According to the efforts you make, the father has come into the corporeal world for a short time. He says, I alone have to give you children this knowledge. I do not have a permanent body of my own. I enter this one's body immediately after Shiva Jayanti. That is the Gita Jayanti. Knowledge begins then only. The Supreme Spirit gives you the spiritual knowledge. There is no question of water. Water cannot be called knowledge. Only with knowledge, not water, do you become pure from impure. There are rivers all over the world. The Father, the ocean of knowledge, comes here, enters this one and speaks knowledge. When someone dies, they put a water of Ganges in his mouth. They believe that that water purifies the impure and that he will therefore go to heaven. Here too, people go to the Gomukh, means the mouth of a cow. In fact, you are leaving Gomukhs. The nectar of knowledge emerges from your mouths. Milk is received from a cow, so there is no question of water. You understand that at this time, you understand that when something happens in the drama, it will repeat identically after 5000 years. The father, who is the bestower of salvation for all, sits here and explains all of this. Everyone is now in a state of degradation. Previously, you didn't understand why people burn an effigy of Ravan. You now understand that there is to be unlimited Dashera. The kingdom of Ravan is over the whole world. The whole world is Lanka. Ravan doesn't live in the limited, means is not restricted to a limited area. There is Ravan's kingdom over the whole world. Devotion lasts for half a cycle. First, there is unadulterated devotion and then adulterated devotion begins. Dashera, Rakshabandhan, etc. are festivals that refers to this time. After Shiva Jayanti, there is Krishna Jayanti. The land of Krishna is now being established. Today, you are in the land of Kans and tomorrow you will be in the land of Krishna. Krishna cannot exist here at this time. Krishna takes birth in the golden age. He is the first prince. He goes to study at school and then when he grows older, he becomes the heir to the throne. The dancing with gopis and gopis is just them celebrating in happiness together. How could it be possible for Krishna to sit and relate knowledge to someone? All of that praise belongs to Shivaba, who purifies the impure. When you explain to the senior officers, they say that what you are saying is right. However, they are not able to give this knowledge to others. No one would listen to them. Everyone would say that he became a BK because he had a magic spell cast on him. They just hear the name of BKs and that's it. They believe that you do magic. When you give even a little knowledge to someone, they say that you BKs perform magic. That you BKs don't listen to anyone except your dada. That you don't perform any devotion, etc. Baba tells you not to forbid anyone to do devotion. They will stop doing it of their own accord. It is when you stop doing devotion and renounce the vices that there is upheaval. Baba has said that when he creates the sacrificial fire of the knowledge of Rudra, the devilish community creates obstacles in this. This is Sri Baba's unlimited sacrificial fire in which human beings change into deities. It is remembered that the flames of destruction emerge from the sacrificial fire of knowledge. Only when the old world is destroyed will you then rule in the new world. People say we are asking for peace, whereas these Brahma Kumaris are asking for destruction. The father explains the whole of this old world is going to be sacrificed in the sacrificial fire of knowledge. This old world is to be set on fire. There will also be natural calamities. Destruction has to take place. All human beings will be crushed like mustard seeds and destroyed, and souls will remain. Everyone can understand that souls are imperishable. There is now to be an unlimited holika, means huge fire, in which all the bodies will be destroyed and the souls will become pure and return home. Anything put into a fire becomes purified. People have sacrificial fires for purification. All of those aspects are physical. The whole world is now to be sacrificed. Establishment definitely has to be completed before destruction takes place. Whenever you explain to anyone, first explain about establishment and then destruction. Establishment is carried out through Brahma. The name Prajapita Brahma is very well known. There are Adidev and Adidevi. There are hundreds of thousands of temples to Jagadamba. They have so many milas for her. You are the children of Jagadamba. You have become those who have knowledge at this time, and you will then become prince and princesses. You became very wealthy. Then on the path of devotion, you asked Lakshmi for perishable wealth and Diwali. You receive everything here. May you have a long life. May you have many children. You know that your lifespan will be 150 years. The father says the more yoga you have, the more your lifespan will increase. You have yoga with Ishwar, God, and became Yogeshwar, means one who has yoga with God. Human beings are Bhogeshwar, those who enlarge in vice. It is said that God washes the clothes of vicious, impure beings. The father says, I am also called the laundryman. I come and cleanse all souls, and they then receive pure new bodies. The father says, I wash all the clothes of the whole world in just a second, simply by being Manmanabhava. Souls and body both became pure. This is magic. Liberation in life in a second. This is such an easy method. By having remembrance of the father, you will become pure. Simply remember the father while walking and moving around. I don't give you any other difficulty at all. You simply have to remember me. It is now your stage of action. At every second, the father says, I have come as the servant of you children. You called out, oh, purifier, come and purify us. Okay, children, I have come, so I am your servant. Am I not? It is when you became very impure that you carry out in distress with great force. I have now come. I come and give you, children, this mantra every cycle. Remember me and you will become pure. This is also the meaning of Manmanabhava. Manmanabhava and Madhyaji Bhava means remember the father and you will become the masters of the land of Vishnu. You have come to claim the kingdom of the land of Vishnu. From being the land of Ravan, it becomes the land of Vishnu. From being the land of Kans, it becomes the land of Krishna. This is explained to you so easily. The father says, finish all attachment to this old world. We have now completed 84 births. We will shed this old costumes and go to the new world. Only by having remembrance will your sins be cut away. You should have this much courage. Those people continue to remember the Brahma element. They believe that they will merge into the Brahma element. However, the Brahma element is the residence. Those people simply sit in tapasya and believe that they will merge into the Brahma element. However, no one can return home. They will not become pure by having yoga with the Brahma element. Not a single one can go back home yet. You have to take rebirth. The father comes and tells you the truth. The true Baba establishes the land of truth. Ravan comes and makes it into the land of falsehood. This is now the confluence age in which you became the most elevated. And this is why it is called the most elevated age. You change from shells into diamonds. This is an unlimited aspect. The highest on high being are deities. You are now sitting at the most elevated confluence age. It is the highest on high father who is making you into the most elevated ones. He gives you the highest on high inheritance of heaven. And so, why do you forget this? The father says, remember me. Children say, Baba, have mercy so that We don't forget. How can that be possible? You have to follow Baba's directions. The father says, remember me and you will become pure from impure. Follow his advice. What blessings can I give you? Achha. To the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says, Namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says, Namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the Dharana. First point, follow everyone of the father's directions and make yourself into a diamond from a shell. Stay in remembrance of the one father and make your costume clean. Second point, you now have to go to your new home. Therefore, have unlimited disinterest in this old home. Have the intoxication that we will create the land of angels on this old graveyard. Blessing, may you be Trikaldarshi and have a view of the future by keeping the elevated image of the confluence age in front of you. Explanation. Before experiencing all attainments in the future, you confluence age Brahmins experience them now. At this time, you attain a double crown, a throne and a tilak and became embodiments of having all rights. In the future, you will have a golden spoon, but at this time, you are becoming like a diamond. Your life became like a diamond. There, you will swing in the swings of gold and diamonds, but here, you swing in Bab Dada's lap, in the swing of super senses joy. So, become Trikaldarshi and experience all attainments by seeing the elevated picture of the present and the future. Slogan, a balance of karma and yoga enables you to claim a right to God's blessings. Om Shanti.